change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook. But even before that, let's say if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
And they're going to be set up in excellent field position up past the 45. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot.
And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. We now proceed to the start of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. A gutsy call there. Yanks at the locker room with a lead, tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They were already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
There's Garoppolo to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Brought down, but after we saw a flashy little move, stop short of the 40. Give him six on the play, and it'll make it second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down. And yet again, it's Garoppolo. Eluding the pressure, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return. By the way, need to pass along a reminder that our ladder for the Madden Challenge Tournament still open in Mud Drafts until February 11th, and the prize pool for the Madden Challenge, folks, $190,000.
And who wouldn't want to participate in something where you could get a piece of $190,000?
That's what I'm wondering.
Get in, get it done. Let's have some fun.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. On first and 10, Locke steps away to his left. Ebron caught left side and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 23 yards on the play. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Locke, escaping the pressure right. He'll get five out of his scramble in second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
To throw his incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
And he's got Rodgers. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
The three red zone trips, three touchdowns so far. They'll look for a fourth on second and goal. Now a carry for Mack. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from the lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin to it.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal. Out of gun. Love. Being chased down left. He can run for it, and he will. So he got three and one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth. No movement from the field goal unit. They've got 4 full yards to go here on fourth and goal to hit Pater, but they're going to go for it.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Staying on the ground with Mack. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him 2 on that run, and they're still left looking at a third and about 9 to go.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Colts on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 9. Lop. Gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Well, they go with a slant that time, 15 yards and a first down.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, You don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and take a good turn. You just go ahead and play.
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 10 more there and another first down.
Well, I'd say that run's pretty emblematic of what we've seen all day long. No matter what they've done on offense, this offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage, given them time to throw it, run it, do whatever they wanted. That's why there are points up on the board. And right now, the psyche of the offense, we're in control, and we can do whatever we feel like doing out here on the field.
They keep it on the ground, Mack again. Push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
They're a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put out the boxing gloves and start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. On fourth down, Luck. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Eric Armstead in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 26. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Man open, it's Goodwin. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
Rush coming in, he's taken down.
Man, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. Throw left side, caught by Goodwin. The Niners on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Now a desperation throw deep. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, 49ers! Dante Pettis with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off inside the 5. Accelerating and goes. And he'll take this across the field. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. On the carry, it's Wilkins. San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Sideline and talk over what to do next. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. Now it's Locke off the bootleg. Looking deep here for Ebron. Now he's got his target. It's caught for a close touchdown.
Get a little ass out of here.